can better be defined as being outside the normal box of aerobatic maneuvers. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, here's Greg Volker, the Sukhoi SC-26. You notice that has quite a different sound. That is a radial engine up front, a Bandinav MV-14. In the front of that airplane is a 9-cylinder radial, anywhere from 360 to 400 horsepower. Now, Rich, look like he's flying a little sideways there. One of the advantages of this airplane is that it is highly capable in gyroscopic maneuvers. For those of you who have ever played with a toy gyroscope, this airplane benefits from that effect quite significantly when he's doing his maneuvers. So whatever you do, don't turn it away. Here we go. Viewpoint on the way down there. He's going to do the other side. Looks like a Q&A. Probably want to be. Watch for it. He's on to the roof in there. And I've lost him. Now, his airplane made its public debut back in 1989 and quickly became the dominant aerobatic aircraft at the World Aerobatic Championships. The design still is world-class to this day, even though there are many other airplanes out there that fly just as good, if not better, than the Sukhoi S-26. One of the neat features of this airplane, as Rick Volker was cranking it around, is that the airplane does not have an electric starter on it. Instead, it is started with compressed air. The engine has a small compressor and there is a tank on board. The reason is because this is a Russian-built airplane. And in Russia, it gets pretty darn cold, let me tell you. A battery would just freeze up in the cold. The electric starter wouldn't have to fizz to crank the engine open. So if you're using compressed air, boom, you get that engine to kick over no problem. And of course, you're probably wondering, well, Fast Eddie, what happens if he runs out of air to start the engine? Well, believe it or not, you can jump the airplane with a scuba tank. One of the limitations on this aircraft is its small main fuel tank. The Soviets were quite aware that pilots might try to defect in this airplane, so they kept the standard fuel supply small enough to give it only an hour of range. They had to fly any further distances than that, they would be given a belly tank to ferry the aircraft. And unfortunately, an internal fight for power within the Sukhoi factory led one of the designers of this airplane to destroy all of the molds that helped build this aircraft. The result is there are only about 60 of these things. So you're looking at a very capable and very rare airplane. Now, one of the interesting things is the wing on this airplane. Now, he's going to pull 10 G's on this. And to help him with that, Rick has competed in various sports to help him cope with the force. Let me tell you what, it's not a smooth ride in this airplane at all. The airplane is capable of 26 G's, that's 26 times the force of gravity, which means that that wing is built like a bridge. There he goes on a vertical rolling it around there. Now the limit placed on the aircraft of plus 12 minus 10 has only been placed to prevent injury to the pilot. The airplane in whiskey, and all the way up to 2016. But long before that, the pilot has been hurt, and hurt bad. Now, you're wondering, plus 12, minus 10? Well, that's easy. When you're pulling on the control stick, that's called positive G's. When you're pushing on the stick, those are negative G's. Because of the way we are built, our bodies can withstand more positive G's than we can negative. Big thing to remember. And here you can see the roll rate on this airplane, which is significant, to say the least. Now, the wings on this airplane have a very fat lead edge on it. This gains in low speed maneuverability. The idea is, while you're doing these maneuvers, you've got to keep that wing flying. And as long as that wing is flying, you're okay. So they stretch up the leading edges on the wings, which gives the airplane excellent slow speed controllability. Because after all, this airplane was never built to break the speed of sound. What it was built for was to dominate the world championship air pass. There's the roll rate. It's a little harder into it there as it goes around. The airplane is notorious for its fast roll rate. More than 360 degrees per second. That is, it'll roll around wingtip to wingtip in less than a second. Now, when you're listening, there goes, he's a bird, and oh, there's the push. I know he threw a push out of it, there it is. All the blood coming to his head. And what is he doing? He's doing aerobatics there the hard way. Let me tell you what, negative cheese can be very painful. You have to go and build up the power to do it. You just can't fly into an airplane and just go zoom and move and expect everything to be all right. You have to work at it. You have to build up the power to the plus and the minus G's, the positive and the negative G's. Greg's going to bring the airplane around here. Might be a photo pass coming up. So what you want to do is get the camera, the camcorder rolling. And here he comes. Ladies and gentlemen, from the left, Rick Volker. This is Sukhoi. You know, if I didn't know any better, I'd say he's having fun with that aircraft. There's that roll rate. He leans on that stick, bangs it into his knee hard, and that airplane comes right around. No hesitation at all.
Contact the